For today's presser is I want to make some announcements in relation to transport. I'm going to ask the Minister of Transport to make some further statements, and then we'll respond to any questions we have in relation to the transport package. At that point, there's a number of other announcements I want to make, and then I'm sure you'll have some questions you want to ask me. So we'll deal with transport issues first and go from there. So today the government is making significant changes to the road and rail funding. These reflect the government's commitment to build transport infrastructure more rapidly, and so that New Zealand can become more productive and grow more quickly. The biggest effects are almost an additional $1 billion will be spent on the state highway network over the next 3 years. In addition to this, and to fund this, we are cancelling the regional fuel tax, which would have added for Aucklanders around about 9.5 cents a litre by 2011. That will be replaced with a nationwide increase in fuel taxes of 3 cents a litre over and above what Labor were planning to introduce, which is effectively 3 cents a litre. So the way that works is on 1 October 2009, there will be an increase of 3 cents a litre. That reflects the 1.5 cents a litre nationwide petrol tax we're putting on and the 1.5 cents that Labor foreshadowed. On 1 October 2010, there'll be a further increase of 3 cents a litre. Again, 1.5 cents for the new nationwide fuel tax we're introducing, and the 1.5 cents that Labor had foreshadowed. I'm confirming today that the government is committed to Auckland's electrification of its rail project, and that we are committed to ensuring that we can unclog the clogged arteries of New Zealand's roading network. So on that basis, I'll hand over to Mr. Joyce. He can make some comments, we can answer some questions, and then, as I say, we can move on from there.
Thank you, Prime Minister. So there's the three announcements. The details are, firstly, the $1 billion more for state highways. That's an additional funding over 3 years, and it will come from three sources. $420 million of it is a reallocation from non-state highway classes in the National Land Transport Fund into the state highway infrastructure class. $258 million is new Crown investment, and that will in effect be paying for the New Zealand Transport Agency's share of the Wellington passenger rail infrastructure, but it's additional money to the fund. And the $283 million increase in fuel taxes commencing firstly October this year and then October 1 next year, replacing regional fuel taxes. Now, the plan will do more than reverse the previous Labor government's projected decrease of 9% in the state highway infrastructure budget over the next 3 years. It will mean that around a total of $3 billion will be invested across the state highway network over the next 3 years. And it also shows that the investment in state highway infrastructure will continue at about a third of the total land transport fund over the 10-year horizon, which means about $10.7 billion over 10 years. Now, that's a much more appropriate level, we believe, for the investment in the state highway network, given the importance of the network to New Zealanders. And that importance is reflected by the fact that around 70% of all freight in New Zealand currently goes by road, and around 84% of people across the country go to work by car, truck or motorbike, and so obviously we need good roads to grow and compete. In regards to the regional fuel taxes, the government will not be proceeding with them. We've been considering them for some time. We believe they are an expensive and inefficient means of collecting revenue. As the Prime Minister said, the previous Labor-led government approved a regional fuel tax for Auckland starting from 2 cents a litre in July this year, going to 9.5 cents per litre in 2 years' time. And this is in addition to national increases in fuel taxes that were scheduled by the previous government of 1.5 cents per litre for the next 3 years. So the total tax increase by 2011 would have been 14 cents per litre for Aucklanders. A number of other regions were starting to consider regional fuel taxes, including Canterbury, Bay of Plenty, Waikato and Wellington. Those will also not be going ahead. Our preference is for a simpler system which delivers benefits to road users across the board. And finally, a comment in regards to Auckland Rail electrification. We are committed to seeing the Auckland Rail electrification going ahead. Rail is an important and growing way for Aucklanders to get to work each day, and we're well past the time where there's a debate about which mode of transport is the right one in Auckland. The reality is that a number of modes are necessary. So OnTrack's electrification plans, their part of the program will proceed unchanged. The purchase of electric trains that was to have come out of the regional fuel tax will now be supported by Crown funding. The government has decided in principle that now that Kiwi Rail has been repurchased, it should be the owner of the new Crown-funded passenger rail stock in both Auckland and Wellington. This will save costs over time and ensure the most efficient use of transport funds and of taxpayers' money. Now, that's a decision in principle at this point, because we will need to take into account the report of the Royal Commission on Auckland Governance. That comes out around the end of this month, and that may recommend changes to Auckland's current transport arrangements. Other Auckland projects which were to be funded through the tax, like Penlink, ferry upgrades and integrated ticketing, will be subject to final funding processes through the New Zealand Transport Agency. In terms of projects that are currently underway, if there is any shortfall from what ARC has committed from their own funds for those projects and for the package altogether, the New Zealand Transport Agency has agreed to consider urgent bids for additional funding if that's required. So happy to take questions. The Crown will be funding passenger rail infrastructure through the consolidated fund, so to an extent that's true. The funding for Auckland Rail, the carriages though, would be anticipated to happen for a period of time until the patronage builds and that subsidy can roll off to a more normal level of passenger subsidy, which occurs for most public transport around the country.
So what are you saying to the taxpayer, saying the price
Now, it won't be going into the land transport fund. The increase in petrol taxes that will be going into the land transport fund, and the land transport fund will no longer be used to pay for Auckland and all Wellington rail infrastructure. So Christchurch will participate along with all the other parts of the country in terms of bidding for projects in that fund as it is now.
But everyone has to pay, whether you're in Greymouth or Christchurch, a cent and a half more, whereas the demands aren't the same on those areas as in Auckland. That was the point of the regional tax in the first place.
In terms of the additional 1.5 cents a year, everybody pays it nationally, that's right, and it will go to projects right across the country, which is, as I've said, will be predominantly state highway infrastructure, and that will be a countrywide set of projects, which is always assessed by the New Zealand Transport Agency. And in terms of the particular Auckland rail electrification, which is what the regional fuel tax was for, that will be funded with assistance from the Crown.
When you announced on the election campaign that you were going to build a number of state highways, including the Waikato Express, I don't recall you saying that you were going to put a national fuel tax on that direction.
That's correct. We didn't say that, but it was at that stage we were assessing the future of regional fuel taxes. You'll recall we said at the time we had concerns about, in fact, the Prime Minister before the election said he had concerns about regional fuel taxes, and particularly a 9.5 cent regional fuel tax in Auckland. We think it's fair, if we're not going to proceed with regional fuel taxes, to have smaller increases across the country, which at the end of the day goes into the fund and will be available for projects across the country. And as we said, it's going to be an additional $1 billion in state highway infrastructure over the next 3 years.
But Auckland's always going to have a much bigger drag on that fund than any other region in the country.
Well, Auckland at the end of the day is one third of the country. And so, give or take the vagaries of funding, you could probably expect it to have about one third of the program from the fund. That's just the reality of the size of the city.
And why is everyone around the country paying the same? I mean, on that argument, wouldn't you therefore say Aucklanders should put a bit more in because they represent so much of what has to be spent?
Well, the reality is that the amount each is paid in each region is obviously scaled according to the number of motorists that are in that region. And so the amounts that are actually generated from road user charges and taxes in say Southland or Taranaki, where I come from, is obviously significantly smaller than that is generated in Auckland.
But it's still on an individual basis, the same amount that people are paying around the country, still paying 1.5 extra at a time.
That's right, and it's the historic method, and it's the way that we've always paid for our roading infrastructure. Actually, prior to 2005, it wasn't hypothecated into the fund. You'll recall that some of it went into the consolidated account. I think the plus for this is that motorists everywhere will be continuing to put their money, will continue to go into the fund, and that we'll have a considerable extra amount of money for state highway infrastructure. Now, will the match particular regions to particular income, if you like, income flow to particular projects? Well, that's up to NZTA. But I would point out that there is things called R funds, which are dedicated as part of the fund to individual regions to ensure there is a spread of activity around the country.
I mean, the sharp end of all this is the reality is at least five regions we're going to put on a regional petrol tax. So the vast bulk of the country, they would have experienced a regional petrol tax anyway. So and secondly, you've got a situation where you have a regional petrol tax, it is hideously complex to administer. And people will start doing all sorts of behavioural changes to avoid paying what would be quite a large petrol tax in the Auckland region, including people storing fuel that they would take out of the region into the region. The state highway network, which is being funded by the country, is essentially used by the country. And to a certain degree, if we can get that state highway network to be more effective, even in the Auckland region, that makes the New Zealand economy more effective, and actually we're all better off for it. So this is a victory, if you like, for simplicity over complexity, and in my view, over the development of a system which will enhance all New Zealanders, and we're paying a small amount for that.
Can I just ask you why you're reducing the public transport emissions and cycling emissions? You've got, you say, you've got $450 million
of reallocation.
That's right. Non-state highway buses.
That's right.
Now, that includes a reduction in public transport.
Well, no, it doesn't actually. What it includes is a reduction on what the previous government was planning to increase them to, all the activity classes, I think, with the possible exception of some of the administration classes, go up over the next 3 years compared to what they have over the last 3 years. And some of those were already at quite large increases. So, yes, we're putting some pressure on some of the, if you like, the non-state highway classes to get better results from those classes, but a lot of them have seen very big growth in the last couple of years, and that growth was projected. And we're saying you actually have to reflect the transport options that are available to New Zealanders. And when 84% of New Zealanders go to and from work each day using the roading system, it doesn't make sense to not be investing properly in that roading system.
But it is true, isn't it, that you're not increasing those public transport and cycling walking ways by as much as
they've
grown?
That's correct. We are not. That's exactly correct. And there are a range of other ones that we're also not doing. So road policing, for example, won't be going up as fast a rate. But again, road policing has gone up by a large amount in the last few years. And we're saying, well, actually, we think we can drive some better results out of that. And we need to put more investment into the state highway infrastructure classes, which will improve the productivity of the whole economy. That's what the Prime Minister was talking of, to ensure that we get the faster growth that we're looking for. Well, as some of you will be aware from a certain newspaper this morning, I wrote to Mike Lee last week as chairman of the Auckland Regional Council, and to talk to him about those things. The big project, of course, is Auckland Rail electrification. It's something like $1 billion out of the 1.4. There are some other projects, as you know, some of them underway, and as I said in the prepared notes before, happy to talk to the ARC if there's any of those that are beyond what they have committed in these transport projects. In terms of the integrated ticketing in particular, that's subject to NZTA, which is already making a sizeable contribution to that, to confirming that they are actually going to proceed with that. And I've said to Mike, let's cross that bridge once we get there. There'll be some detail to work through because it is quite a change, but I'm confident that we can do that.
What about the upgrades on the new station?
Well, that's exactly one. Well, that's underway now, and as I say, I've spoken to NZTA, and if it gets to a point where some urgent bids are required to complete projects, then NZTA are standing by and able to help.
What does this mean for a project like Transmission Gully? Because wasn't that the Wellington fuel tax was supposed to go towards? I mean, there's a huge shortfall here between what the government's prepared to fund and what's needed to build it.
Well, 10.9 or 10.6 or whatever it is, billion dollars over 10 years is actually probably a far bigger investment than we've put previously into the state highway network over any period of time. Now, it is for NZTA to make final decisions as to which projects are funded at which point, but I would expect some quite large projects to be able to be funded out of that.
So does that mean that they would have to be fully funded now from NZTA?
Not necessarily. We'll actually have more to say on particular projects and corridors at a later date, and the government has some views as to which priorities it would like to see over time. And there is still some possibility that you might want to do, and only, again, two or three projects at some point, some form of private public partnership. But what this will mean is a very significant increase in the rate of project in the core state highway investment that comes out of the Land Transport Fund. Now, whether that's sufficient for all the projects, in fact, I'm sure it's not sufficient for all the projects that every region wants to see funded over the next 10 years. It won't reach that because it's a massive amount, but it will achieve quite a lot of progress. In fact, the most progress that we have achieved in building up the state highway infrastructure.
Is Transmission Gully a priority for you?
I'm being quoted as saying I'm on the fence on Transmission Gully. I went and saw it about 10 days ago, the proposed route and also the coastal route. It was very enlightening, and we'll have more to say on that at some stage in the future.
You're still on the fence either way?
At this point, yes.
Is PPP a code for road tolls?
Not necessarily at all, because you can have public-private partnerships without tolls. You can have tolls without public-private partnerships. All we're saying is we're now saying to New Zealand Transport Agency, here's what we're predicting will be available for the fund over the full 10 years, and here's what will be available over the next 3 years. And we want you to now plan the roading program, and so we'll have some input of our own in terms of what we see are national priorities, and we'll talk about that in the near future. But then we want to see how they plan the fund, and they can come back to us and tell us how much progress they're able to make.
Can you explain why, what difference it makes if the Crown owns the new trains and rolling stock, I presume, for the commuter networks?
Mm.
And is that a first step towards Kiwi Rail owning all of those commuter networks?
Well, Kiwi Rail, of course, owns the current rolling stock in the Wellington region and operates them under contract to the Wellington Regional Council. And the government, through the New Zealand Transport Agency, was due to advance a very significant sum of money by way of an interest-free loan to the Wellington Regional Council so it could buy some replacement rolling stock, which we would then hold, and of course it's not a train operator. But that, all of that, to a novice like me, seems like a particularly complicated way of doing things, particularly now that Kiwi Rail is actually owned back in the family, if you like. And given that that's happened, and we've all had views in recent times whether that's a good idea or not, but it has happened, and therefore it probably makes sense for them to continue owning rolling stock.
So there's no rolling stock currently owned by anyone other than
Kiwi Rail? No, ARTA has the diesel rolling stock in Auckland that was set up in that way, we would envisage, as I say, it's been an in-principle decision, the detail has to be worked through, but we would envisage that if we go ahead and confirm that Kiwi Rail was to own the new electric stock in Auckland, that would be an appropriate time for them to pick up the ownership of the rolling stock there.
So in a sense, Kiwi Rail is going to have a monopoly on rolling stock across the country for all passenger service?
You could say that, yes. And in a country of sort of about $4.2 million people, it would seem perhaps
a bit more than that. It's not that bad.
Is it? Oh, good. 4.2 million people, it seems a little bit sort of, maybe a little bit too complicated to have three separate rolling stock owned companies that are being funded by the Crown, which is in effect what's been happening. Even with the regional fuel tax, the government would have been collecting the fuel tax, passing it over to the Auckland region, who would then go out and buy the trains.
Will you have to borrow more for this?
This falls part of the Crown's capital commitment, which was detailed before the election and I think confirmed after the election, the 8.5 or whatever billion it is over 6 years, so it forms part of that.
Is that where the 258 million, the second part of...
That's where the 258 million comes from, yeah, that's correct.
Billion? Yep.
Can I just ask, the $420 million reallocation from non-state highway classes, can you just be a little bit more specific about exactly what those non-state highway classes are? Like, how much of that comes out of the increase that was going to public transport, for example?
I haven't got the full list in front of me, but it comes pretty much across the board. There's some management classes. New Zealand Transport Agency, by the way, as we know, is a merged agency, and we're expecting an efficiency dividend from them in terms of the administration over the next few years. That's been factored into it. The only one we haven't changed at all is renewal of local, is the new and improved infrastructure for local roads, which is kept the same as the previous GPS. All the other ones have all come back a bit, but as I say, most if not all are larger than they have been over the previous 3 years. And what they were doing was going through quite large growth. And what we've said is, well, I've had, in many cases, I've had a reasonable run. And again, reflecting the transport options available to most New Zealanders, we think it's time that the state highway infrastructure got a larger investment. Prime Minister?